everyone, and welcome to another Blade Blur video. As you probably all know, I've made quite a few videos on my channel in the past. A bunch of Sonic videos, but also some top 10 lists. So I thought, well, this is Sonic's 25th anniversary, might as well fuse the two to finally give you a top 10 about Sonic the Hedgehog. The best first levels in Sonic the Hedgehog history.
The first level in a video game is what sets the bar for the entirety of the adventure. And when it comes to Sonic games, there are plenty of categories in which I can rank this list. The level design, backgrounds, set pieces, and of course, awesome Sonic music. Before we begin, a couple of ground rules. First of all, it has to be a platform game, obviously, so don't expect to see any racing games or any kind of spin-offs. And second, while obvious, it has to be the first level when you play as Sonic the Hedgehog himself. Because if that rule wasn't in place, you know what would win. Get it?
Cause you got to play it 10 times.
Enough with the rules, let's start with our top 10 first levels in Sonic the Hedgehog. Or top 10 level 1s in Sonic the Hedgehog. Or top 10 Sonic level 1s. Either way, let's begin with the first level 1. Boy, this is gonna be confusing really fast.
Number 10.
You know this list is gonna be pretty interesting when Emerald Hill Zone from Sonic 2 barely scratches the list.
When I think of Emerald Hill Zone, I think of it as efficiency by the virtue of simplicity. Sure, it's not the most complex level design out there, but it doesn't need to be. In fact, its linearity is one of the key elements why the level works so well. Being able to run faster than the previous game, and performing the spin dash for the very first time, are all milestones first performed in this area. And plus, this level got some awesome corkscrews! Nothing like returning a joke that's not even funny anymore.
Number 9.
Hello everyone, and welcome to the first meeting of Sonic Anonymous. I am Blade Blur. I have a confession to make to you all. I like Sonic Lost World.
It's true that Windy Hill from Sonic Lost World is an anomaly in terms of other Sonic levels, but you know what? After a few minutes combined with the awesome music, I was instantly hooked. By far the most unique first level on the list, debatably ever, Windy Hill introduces a lot of elements exclusive to this game. My favorite part is how much there is to explore in what seems to be a very small platform.
For example, right when the level starts, if you go 180 degrees from your starting point, you can find a brand new path so you can reach the goal in a different way. The main reason why this level isn't any higher is because of the 2D segments, which feel rather mismatched with the control scheme of the game.
But that doesn't stop all the good parts of Lost World shine through, despite its flaws.
While not perfect, this level still gets some extra points because of its inclusion in Super Smash Bros. For the Wii U. I mean, that deserves some kind of merit, right?
Number 8.
You're probably asking yourself, why does Green Hill Zone, the most iconic and memorable Sonic level of all time, is doing rather low on this list? Well, first of all, this is a biased list. This is my personal picks, my favorite first levels in Sonic games. And quite frankly, Green Hill was never my favorite level in Sonic 1. But that being said, it deserves all the praise it gets for being the most influential Sonic level of all time. And here's why.
The importance of Green Hill Zone doesn't stem from simply looking at the level itself, but also its importance for its time. When NES games were mostly stuck on a linear flat path, Green Hill allowed players to explore multiple routes to reach the end of a level. This verticality was a stepping stone of many Sonic levels to follow in the future, as it introduced the concept of multiple paths and therefore extending replayability.
It's rather tricky to put it in words why I don't like Green Hill Zone as much as the average Sonic fan. But if I were to venture a guess, I would probably say I have a serious fatigue from the main level track. Nevertheless, I cannot deny the impact this level had on the Sonic franchise, not to mention it's the most remade Sonic level of all time. And before anyone asks, no, Sonic Generations is not on the list because it doesn't count.
Number 7.
after surviving the horror of the Sonic Dark Ages with games like Shadow the Hedgehog and Sonic 06, it was nice to see Sonic Colors come out of nowhere since it was under the shadow of Sonic 4, and boy did it deliver. And right from the beginning, since the first level, Tropical Resort, is pretty awesome.
If I had to describe why this level made it on the list, style. What makes Tropical Resort unique is the fact it's the only level on this whole list that doesn't take place in a beach, forest area, or some kind of a city. The aesthetics overall are absolutely stunning. For one, I love the clash of neon lights that resemble the casino levels of yore, mixed with the pseudo-Hawaiian resort aesthetic that makes the level feel more tropical. Oh wait, that's why they call the level tropical. Plus, I love those moments when you grind and see the black starry skies and what appears to be Earth in the background, which gives me huge Sonic 3 and Adventure 2 flashbacks. Only reason why this level isn't higher on the list is from a level design standpoint. In my opinion, the 2D only acts are rather anemic without many creative platforming challenges. However, in this specific case, style trumps over substance. And in the case of Sonic Colors, this is not a bad thing at all. Number 6. Next is the rather obscure Leaf Storm from Sonic Rush. It's easy to fault the level for yet again sitting to the usual level conventions, but it makes up for it thanks to the game's further emphasis on speed. The Rush games, by default, are designed for the player to zoom through the levels at breakneck speeds, and the first level definitely sets the stage for the rest of the adventure. And the game's many springs, loop-de-loop, and even bungee jumping can easily help you build up your boost meter. And yes, even though Sonic Rush is the first game to introduce this mechanic, I'd rather regret seeing in Sonic games, but it's okay in the case of Sonic Rush because the game makes you use the fun trick system in order to earn that boost. In fact, it's downright encouraged since there are plenty of moments when Sonic is gonna have high airtime in which you can chain a lot of tricks together and perform awesome feats, so it does feel incredibly rewarding. And to top it all off, at the end there's a pretty cool chase sequence when Sonic gets chased by a giant rolling object, which kinda reminds me of Crash Bandicoot, which that in turn reminds me how that game was originally known as the Sonic Ass game in development. So Crash Bandicoot was inspired by Sonic the Hedgehog, and now Sonic the Hedgehog is being inspired by Crash Bandicoot, and now I'm rambling, I'm sorry. Number 5. Well, let's talk about Sonic Heroes, what might be the most polarizing game in the whole franchise. Since it is placed relatively high on this list, you'd imagine I like it to some extent, and Seaside Hill is definitely a testament as to why. No one can deny how vibrant and lush the colors are in this level, and I love the contrast between the greenery to the orange checkerboard walls that are reminiscent of the Green Hill Zone. Close enough. It also features an additional aesthetic of how the white ruins mesh well with the vast blue ocean. It makes the level feel distinct and not feel like the backgrounds are stretched for a ridiculous amount of space. While Sonic Heroes does involve more combat than usual, Seaside Hill focuses more on speed and platforming, as well as teaching the ropes of how the team mechanic works. What's nice about it is that by experimenting with team formations, there are also alternate paths to explore, and you know I'm a huge sucker for that. And it even has some very distinct set pieces, like the bobsled, the turtle cannon lake, and of course, that chase from those, giant real rock things. And yes, I know that's part of Ocean Palace, but then again, this level does kind of feel like Seaside Hill Act 2, so it counts! Number 4. Okay, it's finally time to shed some light on the Sonic Advance trilogy. You got Neo Green Hill Zone, which is a bit ordinary, yet it's pretty straightforward, whereas Route 99 is robust, yet sometimes too chaotic for its own good. So I decided to go with the Empire Strikes Back of the series, Sonic Advance 2, and its level, Leaf Forest. Frankly, there's not much I can say about this level. It took what worked in Sonic 1 and 2's first levels and pretty much amped it up. You get faster gameplay, bigger loops, and somehow segmented screws, which I'm not sure how that works, but who cares, it's awesome! Thanks to how brisk it is, Leaf Force is just the perfect level to just pick up and play and have fun, regardless of which character you're playing as. even cream, and I don't even like Cream the Rabbit! I am fully aware that I'm on the minority when it comes to liking the second game more than the other two in the trilogy, but trust me, at the very least, you'll adore this first level just like myself. Number 3.
I've been making videos for quite a while now, and I'm surprised I haven't talked about this game yet, but here it is. Sonic the Hedgehog 3. Number 3 on the list, no less, but I freaking adore this game! There's so many good things about it, I can go on and on, but I'll try to condense my thoughts and just harness on specifically why the first level, Angel Island, is so amazing. Your day will come. Trust me.
The scope of the level ramps up immediately when you see Sonic flying on his plane with Tails, and he actually has to go super in order to tread on the mystical island, only to be interrupted by the new fellow commonly known as... and Knuckles. Sometimes a simple presentation can be the most effective. And those little story segments peppered throughout the level definitely help out.
Darn you, Ed Knuckles!
This level is absolutely gorgeous, and there are definitely a myriad of secrets to explore. But just when it gets started to get acclimated to the level, the game throws a curveball. At the halfway point, a flying vehicle appears. You try to jump and destroy it, but nothing happens. All you can witness is it showering the sky with flame bombs as its identical peers soar in the sky as a sheet of fire fills the screen, and the whole tropical layout of the level turns into a burned shell of its former self. This change alone is enough to cement Angel Island to be as high as it is on this list. Not only do the aesthetics of the level are vastly different, but it also gives you a better sense of emanating danger. Not to mention that the segment in which you have to escape the bombardment of the flying battery is quite exhilarating. But if that's not enough, this game further cements its genius design by how Knuckles' path is different than Sonic's. Being able to break those rocks for the first time blew my mind, since when I played the original Sonic 3, I didn't know that it was even possible. I'm gonna toot this game's horn over and over in the future, but for now, Angel Island is an initial appetizer as to why Sonic 3 is such a masterful gaming experience. And I'm still surprised it's actually gonna get better than this. Number 2!
As you'll probably guess, the majority of the first levels of Sonic the Hedgehog take place in either a forest or a beach setting, so might as well recognize the level that does it the best and give the trope the most justice. And that is none other than Emerald Coast from the original Sonic Adventure.
Words can little explain how monumental this level truly is. This was the first time we saw Sonic move in a three-dimensional space. Properly. Let's get one thing out of the way. This level is stunningly beautiful. I mean, it's easy to just gush over and over about the lush environment and how striking the colors are, but to really impress people, we should talk about the loop-de-loops. Just the way the camera snapped to a different position to show how flowing Sonic's motion is takes my breath every single time. And do I seriously have to talk about the whale chase? This is what sold people the Dreamcast. The dynamic camera work, the speed, and of course the tension from the now free wheelie makes this one of the best moments in Sonic history that's impossible to replicate. And trust me, they tried, and spoiler alert, they failed. And if I'm being completely honest, I actually like Big Segment in Emerald Coast. Mostly because you get to explore this secret lagoon with better fish to catch. When I was growing up and I got this game on $99.99, I was absolutely blown away. My dad actually managed to import the game from the United States, and I played it over and over again because I didn't have a memory card at that point. But even then, I didn't care about playing Emerald Coast over and over because I enjoyed the level so much. That's how good it is. And you know what's funny? It's still not number one! Number one!
You probably guessed that this level is gonna be number one, but you know what? It's rightfully deserved. City Escape from Sonic Adventure 2 is not just one of the best Sonic levels of all time, I find to be one of the most intriguing and unique platforming levels of all time of any platform games, and I'm going to explain to you in excruciating detail as to why I love this level so much.
Even right from the setup, it's amazing as Sonic escapes his captors and falls off a chopper with a broken piece of metal to make a makeshift snowboard, for crying out loud.
And then the title card shows up, and it's all silent until you hear those first few notes.
Attention all units.
Ooh, I love it every single time. The fact you're not even platforming as your first act in the game and actually streetboarding in San Francisco already raises the bar for the rest of the level. Though I do find unbelievably hilarious that you could pretty much run into every single vehicle in the street. And considering the huge amount of vandalism here, this is probably the real reason why Sonic ended up in prison again. After a rather exciting opening segment, the level becomes more traditional in its platforming ways. And it's also the very first level where you can use the brand new grinding mechanic, and it's also very cool to perform some awesome tricks to win some really high bonuses. And yeah, there's even a cool camera trick in the loop-de-loop in this level as well, and I gotta love this speed highway-esque run down a building segment, that's also pretty cool. And how can I not mention this monstrosity? This gun truck, or G-U-N, or whatever you like to call them at this point, I don't even know where to begin with this one. Have you seen the size of the other cars in this level? They definitely don't look as big, and it takes the place of the whole street! What about the other oncoming traffic? Or even pedestrians like Big the Cat? I don't know what made them design this homicidal machine, but I'll be a liar if I won't say this was intimidating and exhilarating at the same time. This level is just so replayable, and every single time I play it, I always find something new, like a cool Easter egg. For example, I've never heard about the Item Box Expo. What is it about, and more importantly, why is it lasting from February to September? I mean, I would just go there just to smack the person who thought it would be a good idea to make a robotic monster in the first place! And the cherry on top is the musical anthem of this level, Escape from the City. You all know it, and I definitely want to talk about it more, but this entry is only getting long enough, but I will definitely say this. Whoever came up with an idea to actually make this a vocal track instead of just instrumental is a freaking genius. When it comes to giving the best first impression and setting the bar as high as possible, in my humble opinion, City Escape is the best first level in Sonic history. Once again, we've reached the end of the video, but I do hope you all enjoyed it. This time I want to feature two special channels. First is Nerd Ward Entertainment, and he makes a lot of cool top 10 about Sonic the Hedgehog, so if you want to check his top 10 level 1 music tracks, click on the right. And if you want to see me complete Sonic 2 with my good friend Dan Seibert in Game Tavern, well, click on the left. And of course there's a Sonic CD review in the middle if you want to see that too. Until the next time, guys, take care.